Utah is not scheduled to make another trip to Logan, Utah. So the 110th meeting between the Aggies and the Utes is Utah State's opportunity to take advantage by beating the Utes from the Pac-12. Travis Reynolds on the return. There's a flag down as Reynolds gets to the 23-yard line. Back at Romney Stadium, Carter Blackburn, Rod Gilmore, Jamel Hill.
During the return, illegal block in the back by the return team number 3. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Amazingly, last year, Utah State 3 times overcame double-digit leads. 4 times they lost double-digit leads, including that thrilling opener against Auburn. Then on September 30th, the lead against BYU, 27-24. Riley Nelson sneaks that one through. And then in the first bowl game since 1997 in Boise, that's Tyler Tettleton getting into the end zone for Ohio. And another come-from-behind win against the Aggies. This was a thrill ride team in 2011.
Second half adjustments will be key.
Chucky Keaton hands off to Kerwin Williams. Minimal gain on first down. So Utah State in 2011, they started the year 2-5. Those close losses to Auburn and BYU, rallied to win 5 straight. They made it to the bowl and then lose another tight one against Ohio.
Well, they've got a double-digit lead here tonight. How do you adjust in the second half so that you don't give up that lead?
Only the Aggies of Texas A&M lost more. But a solid start to the second half as Travis Reynolds hauls it in behind him for the Utah State first down to the 35.
Well, that ball was thrown behind him, but that was where it needed to be. And now they're changing the tempo. Not a lot of tempo change in the first half, but here they go now, line of scrimmage. Option was a big play for them in the first half. They'll need that in the second half and something else on offense.
Chucky Keaton, the sophomore quarterback from Houston, Texas. Cypress Creek High School from the shotgun. There's the option. Keaton keeps it for only a couple. Dave Kruger, the defensive tackle on the stop.
Yeah, the option was a big play for them. It helped them in the first half on first down. They had a lot of second and four situations in the first half. If they can continue to do things on first down, then they will have this defense on its heels like they've had them most of the night.
Star Lotulelei in the middle of the Utah defense. Second and 8. In motion. Keaton fires complete on the slant to Chuck Jacobs across midfield.
Well, you can see on this drive, the second half adjustment has been to just quick passes, quick slants inside with tempo. They hurry to the line of scrimmage. There is the big fella we've been watching all night. Lotulelei, likely to be a top 5, top 6 pick in next year's draft.
The ruling on the field is that the Utah State runner was down prior to the ball coming out. Utah is challenging that ruling.
So this goes to the replay booth, even though Sean Hockley gets on the phone there. It's the replay group's call.
Well, because he was ruled down, now you have to have evidence to show that the ball was out before he went down. From that angle, it looked like the ball was out, like he lost possession before he went down. That first view was a pretty clear view that the ball was out. Look right there. That ball is out and he's not down. That, to me, is substantial evidence. That's pretty clear that that one's going to get overturned.
Keep this in mind not only for this replay, but everyone you see throughout the college football season. The rule says replay official must be convinced beyond all doubt by indisputable video evidence that one or more video replays provided to the monitor.
Yeah, there wasn't a knee anywhere close to the ground, and that ball was coming out.
Talk to replay officials, they say they're looking for a clear picture. They want a picture that says there's no doubt in order to overturn.
Was that clear?
No, it looked pretty clear.
Yeah, clear to me.
That looks like indisputable video evidence to me.
Well, I'm sure they're checking that, but they're also checking where was the ball recovered? Where would you spot it?
One of the reasons why these delays on replays take longer than you would normally think they would. They have to look at the spot, they have to look at the clock, they have to get all of that right. So if it is overturned Utah football, where is it Utah football?
There's another clear look at that ball out, and where is the recovery? There it is right there. That looks like that's around the 47. 48 from that angle.
Now, did Trevor Riley pick up that football, and was Riley ever down? Or where? That ball's clearly out.
Yeah, it was Riley 9 who came up with it.
The ball was coming loose in the runner's hands prior to his knee hitting the ground. Because Utah recovered the ball in the immediate aftermath of the fumble, they will be awarded possession at the 47-yard line. Utah is not charged a timeout, and they will have one timeout. They will have one challenge remaining. First down.
So because Kyle Whittingham wins that challenge, not charged with a timeout, opportunity to challenge.
Well, and that's the momentum shift that Utah needed. And this was about to be a big play for Utah State. Give them a first down. The momentum was continuing. Now Utah's back, and this is great field position. They're almost at midfield. New quarterback, well, old quarterback, because Hayes came in late in the first half after Wynn was knocked out of the game.
Chopley is the player who knocks it away. Riley recovers. John Hayes, the senior, again in place of the injured Jordan Wynn. Handing off. White on first down across the 50. Let's check in with Jamel Hill.
Yeah, guys, I talked to Coach Whittingham at halftime, and he confirmed that Jordan Wynn, he's getting x-rays right now. He has a right injury, I'm sorry, to his left shoulder. And if you recall, he had surgery already on the right shoulder. I asked him how they can have a better game plan in terms of blocking people, and he said they're not doing anything special. All we have to do is do a better job of picking folks up.
So with Jordan Wynn injured again, it's John Hayes quarterbacking the Utes. Second down, pass complete. To the 40-yard line, Christopher has a Utah first down. And how much difference do you see in the Utah offense with John Hayes at quarterback?
Well, they're going to quick step. That was a three-step get rid of the ball. They couldn't protect the quarterback in the first half. So now the game plan appears to be, based on that first play, get the ball out faster. Because they can't block it. They had the quarterback hit 10 times in the first half.
And Travis Wilson, the true freshman, now comes on at quarterback for Utah. So the Utes have used three quarterbacks. Wilson, the true freshman from San Clemente, California. Inside give, White straight ahead as the Utes are starting to get the ground game going. White near another first down inside the 30.
They leave Wilson on the field on first down. Now, last week, Wilson only ran the ball inside the 20 in the red zone. Now they have to use him. Does he have enough command of the offense to run the plays on first down? Do they keep it basic? They go two backs here. This has typically been their run formation.
Wilson's a true freshman, went through spring ball, graduated high school early to join the Utes. Toss back. Wilson heaves it to the end zone. It is caught for a Utah touchdown. Kenneth Scott hauls it in on the flea flicker for a touchdown.
And Scott was not open. He just outjumped everybody. How about Travis Wilson with the confidence just to put it up there and let Scott go get it? He's not open. He just puts it up there. Two guys are there, but Scott goes up to get it.
Peterson missed the PAT last week against Northern Colorado. This one is good. Well, like the fight song says, I am a Utah man, sir, and I live across the green. Our game is the jolliest you've ever seen.
Did you just say Jolly Green?
The jolliest you've ever seen.
College Football in High Definition is presented by Vizio.
When the sun was up, it was all Utah State Aggies. A 13-0 start for the Aggies from the WAC. But Utah, in its second year in the Pac-12, has come back with 10 straight. We have a field goal game early in the third quarter as the Aggies grab it. Glover Wright across the 20 to the 25-yard line. So, Rod, the Utah State Aggies had their goal of taking the fight to Utah early on, dominated this football game. Now Utah's counterpunched. What can we expect now from Utah State the second half?
Well, Utah State's offense hasn't punched back since late in the first quarter. They haven't sustained a drive. They need to do that. The option has worked for them, and we saw in the last series for them the three-step pass has been working. But they have to find a way to make a play. The momentum is coming back from Utah. So, Chucky Keaton, time to get a play done.
Star Lotulelei has not been a huge factor in the middle for Utah. He's at right tackle now, number 92 for the Utes. Number 9 on Mel Kiper's big board. Keaton, quick hitter, dragging tight end. That's Bartlett across the 30-yard line. Bartlett has 5 catches in the game now for Utah State.
Yeah, Star's been taken out of this game because of the tempo, the options to the wide field, the rolling the quarterback out, making him run from side to side, has taken his effectiveness out of this game so far.
The one force fumble, the big play from Lotulelei. Back to the tight end, Bartlett. Catch number 6 for Bartlett. He grabbed it right around the 35, where his forward progress was stopped by Filiane, redshirt freshman linebacker.
The adjustment continues. It's the same thing we saw coming out of half. Quick passes and tempo. They've changed the tempo. They're going quick, hurry up, trying to limit what Utah can do with substitutions. This has been their option set.
Hill and Williams join Keaton in the backfield. Keaton keeps it, fakes the give to Hill, and then keeps it for a gain of about 3.
Well, what they've been trying to do on first down is get to about 2nd and 6. When they're at 2nd and 6, that allows them to use option or quick passes on 2nd down and sustain drives.
And here we are.
Yep.
2nd and 6.
Well, now they have the choice. They can go option out of this formation or quick pass.
Utah shows pressure. Keaton spins away from the pressure from Dave Kruger and sails it all the way into the herd. There's a souvenir for some lucky fan.
Well, he doesn't have a receiver anywhere over there at all.
Line of scrimmage with the football. And he third down.
Outside the pocket, and he got the ball beyond the line of scrimmage. What a great job of explaining the non-call there. Mm-hmm. No receiver in the area, but he got the ball beyond the line of scrimmage. He's outside the pocket.
Meaning 3rd down and 6 for Keaton and the Aggies.
There's Lotulelei.
Flag down, motion on the line. Lakelock was right around 0, but there was motion.
Number 99 of the defense moved into the neutral zone, causing the offense to react. Offside by the defense, 3rd down, 5-yard penalty.
That's Joe Kruger, meaning it's 3rd down and 1 for Utah State.
This opens up the playbook again. This is Chucky Keaton time. He can hang on to the football. Run it, option. They've got choices here with him.
Pistol look on 3rd and 1. More motion on the line.
Although the defensive lineman shifted, no one entered the neutral zone. Therefore, false start by the offense. 5 yards, 3rd down.
Sean Ockley's continuing for an Emmy.
Yeah, I mean, talk about classic explanations. You saw the shift and the move. You can cut those explanations out and use them for teaching.
Yes, and you should. So back to third and six. Keaton throws, complete. Austin appears to be about a yard shy of the first down. Ridden out of bounds by Ryan Lacy.
Good tackle by Lacy. Lacy is not the biggest quarterback, but he is considered quite a prospect over there.
Fourth and one, punt unit coming on. Tyler Bennett, senior from Phoenix, Arizona, kicks it to Jeff Norwood. Bounces at the 20. Norwood picks it up. Dropped at the 14-yard line. Utah, a touchdown drive. Last time they had the football to get back in the game.
College Football Primetime, brought to you by Domino's, Oh Yes We Did, and Samsung, the next big thing is here.
Just 2 days ago, Utah State Athletics held a groundbreaking ceremony for a new strength and conditioning center located in the northwest corner of Romney Stadium. Will be the largest of its kind in the Mountain West Conference, where Utah State will be playing in 2013. As college football continues to shift, Utah second year in the Pac-12, Utah State will contend, expected with Louisiana Tech, for the WAC this year before they're on to the Mountain West. John Hayes under center for the Utes in place of the injured Jordan Wynn, handing off on first down to John White for a minimal gain. College football continues. ESPN and ESPN2, 7 Eastern. It is Washington versus LSU, presented by Hampton Hotels. 7:45 ESPN2, Georgia, Missouri.
Yeah, and that's another change. Missouri in their SEC opener. You'll notice Georgia may have as many as 4 defensive starters missing from that game. Suspended, team violations. Not clear exactly why.
Second and 7 out of the eye. Short gain for White. You mentioned all the suspensions around college football. We don't know about all those different scenarios. We know Greg Reed, Florida State, Tyrann Mathieu, LSU. Those were drug-related suspensions. That's out in the public. It is an emerging concern in college football.
Yeah, how about Oregon deciding just recently to start random drug testing following an article on ESPN the magazine last April that speculated about heavy marijuana use there, and Oregon responding to that. Oregon State jumping up and saying, hey, they'd follow on too and do it.
Prior to 3rd and 5, timeout Utah State. Field goal game
timeout
here, a big 3rd and 5 coming for Utah. On Twitter right now, the Utah quarterback situation. Jordan Wynn out, John Hayes quarterbacking, Travis Wilson, the true freshman, is trending right now on Twitter. The buzz growing for the true freshman quarterback of San Clemente, California. That is Jordan Wynn, unfortunately, with his left arm in a sling. Already 3 shoulder surgeries. Both shoulders have been operated on for Jordan Wynn. 3rd down, Hayes, play action, incomplete, right on the hands of Reggie Dunn, who couldn't haul it in.
And Carter, just to clean up the point we were talking about with Georgia and their 4 players suspended or likely suspended, team violations, we're not certain of what that situation are. They don't disclose what the team violations are. The Oregon situation and others have been clear, and it's just going to be interesting to see if other schools follow suit with Oregon and go to random testing, even though Oregon's procedure right now is temporary.
That is an emerging trend and concern in college football. So for the hardcore college football fans, something to keep an eye on. Utah's 7th punt, fair caught by Webb right around the 38-yard line. Well, this is Friday night football and a good one between Utah State and Utah. Monday night football returns. Primetime doubleheader. Monday night countdown at 5, then 7. Face off the NFC North. Bengals open their season against reigning division champ the Ravens. 10-15, another division battle as the Chargers take on the Raiders in Oakland. There's no NFC North battle in there, by the way, but it's a doubleheader nonetheless.
Two for the price of one.
Bengals, Ravens, Chargers, Oakland.
Utah defensively focusing on shutting down the option, bringing pressure that time. They identify the option formation that Utah State wants to use. They've decided to bring pressure and take that play away.
Keaton from the gun on second and seven with Kerwin Williams and Robert Marshall with him in the backfield. Off the play fake. Hit as he throws. Fumble the football. Recovered by Utah at the 43. Fakahofua recovers. Joe Kruger lays the lick on Chucky Keaton.
But we talked about that defensive line. Kruger and his brother, Joe Kruger. Those guys are both likely draft picks to go along with Lotulelei. Watch the hit from the backside. 99, Joe Kruger. 6'7", 280. Was the arm going forward? The ruling on the field was no. Does the arm, if it moves forward at all, the benefit of the doubt goes to the quarterback? No. That ball was down. It was not moving forward. That's a good call on the field.
Utah State's second lost fumble this half. Joe Kruger, the junior, on the defensive line with older brother Dave. Paul Kruger is now a defensive end for the Ravens. So you can see on Monday Night Football.
The ruling on the field is a fumble. The ruling is under further review.
The timing on that play was blown up. That play is designed for the ball to be thrown quickly. And Chucky Keaton held on to it way too long. Once you get past that beat of right now, you have to get rid of that football. You see the arm was not coming forward.
When the ball came out, Keaton's arm goes forward after the ball comes out.
Now he's hit, ball is out, now the arm goes forward. And that's a tough call, but a really good call. I think that was done the right way there. And the rule is such that if it's close, if it's any doubt, the tie goes to the quarterback. But this one is clear to me. That arm is not going forward. He's bringing it back. And remember, you need indisputable video evidence, and you certainly can't look at that and say it's absolutely certain that the arm was moving forward. So I think you can confirm. I would confirm the call on the field. At worst, you'd have to say there's not enough to overturn.
And again, the key is when the ball comes out. Obviously, Chucky Keaton's arm goes forward after the ball comes out, after Kruger applies that hit. Here's the call.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. The ball came loose in the quarterback's hand before his arm started forward. First down, Utah.
When you hear a referee say confirmed, that means the replay booth took a look at it. Not only do they have enough to overturn it, they say, yes, that call on the field is correct.
Yeah, guys, on the field, you got it right. That's what they're saying. How about this for Utah State? Two possessions in the second half, two turnovers.
Fumble, fumble. Now can Utah capitalize after trailing 13-0? The Utes have an opportunity to take their first lead of the night. Hayes under center. Hayes hands it off. Anderson on the sweep gets to the 40. That's Drez Anderson, the sophomore, son of Willie Flipper Anderson. Cade Brady on the stop at the 40. It's been since 1997 that the Utah State Aggies have defeated the Utah Utes. Last year, Utah State lost four games after leading by double digits in the second half. It was a rough second half for the Aggies around college football. Hayes, quick drop, slant, complete. Christopher to the 24-yard line.
Well, he's the guy. The quarterback is reading Christopher. When they single up with him, he goes to him. If they play off, if they double him, he looks the other way. But they try and isolate him over there by himself and see how Utah State will defend him.
John Hayes is now 6 of 8 passing. Jordan Wynn was 6 of 11 when he was in the game, injured on the Utah sideline. Update coming in a moment. White No gain. Let's check in with Jamel Hill.
Yeah, guys, a quick update on Jordan Wynn. X-rays have come back, and they were negative. And also, as an aside, many of his teammates have come up to him giving him words of encouragement. And one of the first people he hugged when he got to the sideline was John Hayes. So it appears that all of his teammates are fully supporting him, and they realize what he's been through.
Well, Jordan Wynn, who's been through the three shoulder surgeries, said it was almost weird, a blessing to be back on the field. Now he's on the sideline again. Travis Wilson comes in on second down for Utah. This is second down and 10 for Utah. Wilson's going to keep it. Tripped up by Fili Moyatu. Short gain for Wilson.
Well, he's athletic and he can run the ball. They use him a bit, but now you've got a big third down. And what's worked for you in the second half? How about Christopher? I mean, they have looked to him and read the way that Utah State has played him.
Christopher, number 10, he's joining the huddle right now. John Hayes coming back in to quarterback. So third down and 8. Hayes at quarterback. Keep an eye on number 10, Devontae Christopher.
Well, there he is right there. Now,
Hayes just gets the snap off. Throws incomplete. A rushed John Hayes trying to get that play off. It was designed for Christopher, but the timing was off. Fourth down.
But they're in position for another field goal attempt. The keys have been clear in the second half. Yeah, they've tried to run the ball a bit, and they've tried to use Christopher and see how the Utah State plays him.
Coleman Peterson hit a 42-yarder at the end of the half. He missed a 27-yarder last week. This is from 40. Peterson's kick is good, and we are tied at 13. It was a 13-0 lead for Utah State, and that field goal from Coleman Peterson evens it at 13. Celebrating its 8th year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship fund for each field goal and extra point kick. To date, Allstate has contributed more than $2.6 million in scholarship monies. Friday night, college football primetime, presented by Russell Athletic, Carter Blackburn, Rod Gilmore, Jamel Hill. The game that they call the Battle of the Brothers. It has been 12 straight wins for Utah. I have to go back to 1997 since the Aggies of Utah State knocked off the Utes. This is the last meeting scheduled in Logan, Utah. Aggies 13-0 start. Utah has fought back with their quarterback Jordan Wynn on the sideline to tie it at 13.
Two drives in the second half for Utah State. Two turnovers. No points since the first quarter.
Nick Marsh's kick right to the goal line, brought out by Glover Wright. Glover Wright across the 25, Glover Wright to near the 35 as we check in with Chris Carter.
Carter, we're giving fans endless coverage with this Olive Garden studio update. Over on the U, a little high school football, Skyline of Washington and Cottonwood of Utah. That's Max Brown, the quarterback, the number 2 ranked pocket passer in the ESPN 150 rankings. He's going to USC next year with the touchdown pass. Now, this is Cooper Bateman from Cottonwood. He throws the pick 6, one of 2 interceptions on the game. He's headed to Bama. And my understanding is Cottonwood is just a beautiful 2-hour drive from where you guys are in Logan.
Home of the Utah State Aggies and quarterback Chucky Keaton. First and 10 from the 35. Keaton, draw. Flag down, Chucky Keaton across the 40 to the 45, but a flag down right around the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, last 6 possessions for Utah State. 3 punts, 2 fumbles, and a missed field goal.
Holding by the offense number 58, hook and restrict, 10 yards, replay, first down.
So after that hot start, by Gary Anderson's Utah State Aggies, last 6 possessions, including those 2 turnovers.
Well, you saw that last play. They came out with an adjustment. They're trying to spread the field, identify pass rushers, and create more space for Chucky Keaton.
Sophomore QB from Houston, Texas, Cypress Creek High School. After the hold, first and 20. Option, handoff, Kerwin Williams. He is dropped right around the line of scrimmage. Trevor Riley got there along with Quade Chopwood.
Yeah, Trevor Riley blew that play up. He's an outside linebacker, sometimes plays at the defensive end spot. They move him around. He's very, very active. And he got to the line of scrimmage, turned that play inside. At some point, Chucky Keaton's going to have to throw the ball down the field.
Keaton flings it in the flat on the screen. Reynolds, short gain. This is third and long coming up for Utah State.
They haven't had a mid-range or deep passing attack tonight.
Longest pass was 24 yards to Reynolds. This is third down and 16.
There's the big fella.
Star Lotulelei, the senior number 9 on Mel Kiper's big board. Lined up right against the center, Tyler Larson. Keaton goes scrambling on third and 16, complete to the sideline, short of the first down, however. Cameron Webb hauls it in, but it will be fourth down and about 4. Punting unit comes on.
Keaton throws very well on the move. And that may be a further adjustment in this ball game, is to get him to the edge and let him throw, get him out of the pocket. Now, this is a field position game right now for them.
Tyler Bennett boots this one all the way into the end zone. That's a touchback. Utah football at the 20-yard line. 13 unanswered points by Utah. They'll have a chance to take the lead. The SEC center stage with Texas A&M's first game of 2012. First game in the SEC against those Florida Gators, 3:30 Eastern time. Jeff Driscoll starts for Florida. Johnny Manziel starts, the redshirt freshman for Texas A&M.
Second game for Florida. They should be cleaner than they were last week with 14 penalties. First game of the season for A&M.
I don't know how the Aggies are going to play, but Kyle Field will be an electric environment to
rocking, just rocking.
Game day will get you started beginning at 9 a.m. Eastern on ESPNU. Hayes, deep bomb, incomplete, just overshoots Kenneth Scott. And what a shot from John Hayes.
Well, Terrence Alston, number 5, did a nice job. Actually, that wasn't Alston, that was Sanders, Cameron Sanders, holding him up. Now, the quarterbacks tonight, Jordan Wynn struggled. 7 drives, no points, 6 punts and a fumble. John Hayes and Travis Wilson together have put together 2 scoring drives and 2 field goals and a touchdown, including off of 2 fumbles.
40-yard field goal. Last time Utah had it to tie it at 13. Blitz coming. Hayes pass tipped away, and it is incomplete. There's a flag down. Looks like pass interference on the defense.
That's Kyler Thackrell, and he went through the man, it looked like. Now, if the ball is just in play and he goes after it, he's got a right to go for the ball, but you can't go through the receiver. He goes through the receiver, and that's the flag. He has the right to go for the ball, but he cannot go through the back.
Before the ball was tipped, number 52 played through the receiver's back. Pass interference by the defense. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Key there is before the ball was tipped.
Have the right to go for the ball as a defender. No problem with that. You just can't do it like that. You can't go through the receiver to get to the ball.
That's a spot foul because it's less than 15 yards. First and 10, Utah. Pressure picked up. Hayes completes. Wolf grabs it right around the 42, but another flag down.
Personal foul, tripping by the offense number 15. Leg whip after the defender was past him. half the distance to the goal. Replay. First down.
That's John White, the senior captain running back.
Well, you know, the first half, they had trouble protecting the quarterback. And I'm sure at halftime, the message was protect the quarterback. Now here he throws and he misses. And you see the little extension at the end with the foot. That's a little telltale sign he was trying to trip.
Making it first down and 23 for Utah. White gets the handoff. Back to about the 15.
To Utah, you think in terms of two plays. Brian Johnson, the offensive coordinator, still a long way to go here. You've got two plays to make this up. Try and pick up 6, 8, 10 and make third down manageable. They've been working the linebackers with the tight ends in the second half, trying to get in between them. Here's the youngest offensive coordinator in all of college football.
25 years old. White gets it on second and 19, so back to the 20, meaning third down and about 15. Well, beginning 9 a.m. Eastern on ESPNU, 10 a.m. on ESPN from College Station, Texas. All access, Steve Sarkisian and the Huskies head to LSU.
I am definitely interested in that Savannah State phenomenon. They get Florida State. They are underdogs by 70 points. Why are they playing those games?
Greg Reed is injured for Savannah State. That maybe has affected the way the experts think of that one.
No upside to those paycheck games like that.
Except the paycheck. Flag is down.
That paycheck is not helping the players.
Full start by the offense number 79. 5 yards. Third down.
Jamel, you want to weigh in on Savannah State?
Yeah, I mean, I know it seems pretty absurd, but we have to remember that programs like Savannah State, they're using that money to build brand new facilities. I've been to Savannah State, and trust me, everything there athletically is in need of a huge upgrade. So while it's distasteful for college football fans, it means a lot to these universities.
Well, so let's go ahead and take these guys and exploit them for the good of sake of good old you, huh?
We'll continue that discussion in the fourth quarter, and more importantly, we have a terrific football game. Tied at 13, headed to the fourth.